हेलो, वेलकम टू नेक्स्ट सेशन। इन दिस सेशन वी विल सॉल्व ग्रेड 2018 एचटी सेगमेंट पेपर। इन द पेपर नोटेशन यूज्ड आर टी प्रेशर, बी वॉल्यूम, टी टेंपरेचर, एस स्पेसिफिक एंट्रोपी, एच स्पेसिफिक एंथैल्पी, सीपी मोलर हीट कैपेसिटी एट कांस्टेंट प्रेशर, सीवी मोलर हीट कैपेसिटी एट कांस्टेंट वॉल्यूम, आर यूनिवर्सल गैस फंक्शन। द क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 इज व्हेन ए फिक्स्ड मास ऑफ एयर When a fixed mass of air water vapor mixture is heated at constant pressure, option A is both relative and specific humidity decrease. B, relative humidity decrease but the specific humidity remains unchanged. C, specific humidity decrease but relative humidity remains unchanged. D, both relative and specific humidity decrease. So this is the sensible heating process. Okay, sensible heating process. With specific humidity constant, okay, and relative humidity is shown in shown here, and diagram humidity is here. So this is cyclometric chart and this is sensitivity mixture. Okay, and you can see that specific humidity remains constant and the relative humidity goes on decreasing. So answer is your B answer. Okay, so one to show the heating on cyclometric chart where the phi decreases. And omega remains constant. Okay. Next, for a reversible isothermal expansion of 1 mole of an ideal gas from state 1 to state 2, the magnitude of work done. Option A, RT ln P1 by V2, B, P2 V2 minus P1 V1, C, RN, R ln V1 by V2, D, 0. So here the isothermal work done, we know the work done, we know that PdV equation, okay, and with V2 and V1 at limit because of final length initial volume. Okay, so now P is your, for P in ideal gas is your RT by V, okay, putting P this quantity, so it will be RT dV by V, okay, integrating it will give RT ln V2 by V1. Okay. Now, for isothermal process, in ideal gas, P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. And so P2 by P1 is equal to V1 by V2. Okay. So, putting these values, we can have WRT ln P1 by P2. Okay. So, answer is option A. Okay. Next, the statement which is not a consequence of first law of thermodynamics is A, heat is a path function. B, energy is a property of a system. C, energy of an isothermal system is not conserved. D, perpetual motion machine of first kind is not possible. According to first law of thermodynamics, heat is a path function and it is not a property of system. Okay. Heat and work both are the path function and not the property of system. Whereas energy is the property of system and it depends upon the condition, it is a point function. Okay, and so both statements are correct, A and B are correct. But for an isolated system, the energy according to first law of thermodynamics remains conserved, because in an isolated system, no energy transfer takes place from or to the system. Okay, so energy remains conserved. Answer is C, and taken up the option also. A perpetual motion machine of first kind is not possible. According to first law of thermodynamics, a perpetual motion machine which can supply, deliver work without any heat input. Is not possible. Okay, so a machine which can supply all work automatically without any source of heat is perpetual motion machine of first kind, and this is not possible according to first law of thermodynamics, because according to first law of thermodynamics, the energy can change its form from one form to another form, or heat can change from work. Okay. So that is the first law of thermodynamics. So this is wrong statement. So this is right statement because it is not possible. Okay. So answer is your C. Okay. Left. For a refrigerator absorbing QL from a cold region and rejecting heat QH to a hot region, the capital performance is written as A QL divided by QH minus QL, B QH divided by QH minus QL, C QH minus QL by QL, D QL by QH. So in the refrigerator, the refrigerating effect is QL, okay, and the work done is your difference of these two, QH minus QL, okay. So COP is nothing but refrigerating effect by work done, so it is QL divided by QH minus QL. So answer is your A. Next, the value of compressibility factor at critical point using van der Waals equation of state is option A, 2 by 7, B, 5 by 8, C, 3 by 8 and D, 1 by 7. Okay. Now we have to calculate the compressibility factor using van der Waals equation. So this is the van der Waals equation. P plus 1, 2 plus A by D square, D minus D, RT. Okay. And writing in terms of P, we can have RT, D minus D, minus A by D square. Okay. So this is your P. And now, this can also be modified like this. Okay. Now we have to calculate the compressibility factor at critical point. Okay. So the graph PV drawn, according to this, the graph has been drawn. So this is the graph. Okay. And this is your isothermal process. Okay. And this is critical point. We have to calculate the compressibility factor like this. So this is neither a maximum or nor a minimum, okay, but it has the maximum is the maximum of this curve is not of, cannot be obtained, okay, because there is no maximum for this curve. It will go on the pressure will go on increasing, okay, and by decreasing volume, and pressure will go on pressure will go on decreasing by increasing volume. Okay. It will go on decreasing by increasing volume. So this is the point where we can have the slope of the PV curve at zero. And this is not the maximum point, and this is neither the maximum point nor the minimum point. So this is the point of inflection. Okay. Here the change in slope of the PV curve is also zero. Okay. So here the slope of this PV curve is zero, okay, and the change in slope is also zero, okay. Change in slope is also zero. Okay, now we have this equation. P is equal to this point P. Okay, now differentiating it, we get by and putting T is equal to TC, RTC, BC minus D square, and plus 2A, BC cube is equal to zero, okay. And again differentiating it because slope is zero, okay. Again, the pressure limit, we get 2R TC, BC minus D cube, minus 6A, BC 4, is equal to 0. Okay? So these are the two curves. These are the slope and change in slope. Okay. These are the slope and change in slope. So from these two equations, we can get B, by solving this equation, we can get B is equal to 1 by 3 BC and R is equal to 8A9 divided by 9 BCBC. You can first solve it for B, okay, by multiplying here BC minus, dividing BC minus B square, okay, and multiplying by 2, and then put B here and find out this R, okay. So this is not very long procedure, okay, but we are using it as it is. So B is equal to 1 by 3 BC and R is equal to 8 by 9 A PC BC, okay. So now we have R, okay. Now use equation 1, so this is equation 1, okay, and put the value of R and B. So we can have a kind of we can have value of a is equal to 3 pcb c square. Okay, so this value of a will be put here to find out r in terms of pcb c and dc. Okay, so then we will have r is equal to 8 by 3 pcb c by dc. Now pcb c by pcb c by r dc is nothing but z. Okay, that is compressive vector, that will be extra vector, but z is your that is your 8 by 3. Okay, sorry, pcb c by r dc. Sorry, z is your 3 by 8. So answer is option C. Okay, answer is option C. So put, change it. And 3 by 8, okay. Or we make it 1 by 8. So that is your 3 by 8. Next, the vapor pressure of a liquid at 8 degree Celsius is 2.7 kp. Its enthalpy of evaporation is constant and equal to 42700 kilojoules per kilomole. Take R is equal to 8.314 kilojoules per kilomole and the temperature in degree Celsius at a vapor pressure 13.5 kp is. Now we have two pressures, one is 2.7 kPa and temperature at this pressure is 18 Celsius and other pressure is your 13.5 kPa and solution temperature we have to find out on this pressure. Okay. Now we have this Kaplan, the classic Kaplan equation, that is L by V dash minus V. Now this small v is generally small as compared to v dash. Okay, and L is given as 42700 kilojoules per kilomole. Okay, so P v dash is equal to nr bar t. Okay, so v dash is equal to r bar t by p. Okay, n is 1. Okay, now your v dash is equal to r bar t by p. Okay, now putting the value of v dash here and taking v as 0, okay, because it is very small, we get dp by t l into p divided by r t square. Okay, so this this dp by p, this dp by p is equal to l by r dt by t square. Okay, so this equation we have derived earlier also in these papers. Okay, now integrating, we get LNP P1 P2 limits minus L by R 1 by T P1 P2 limit. Okay, putting the limits, now we have two pressure, P1 has 2.7 and P2 has 13.5. P1 has 8 degrees Celsius or 1 by 2 81 and T2 is other temperature, so L is your 42700 and R is your 8.314. So we can have this 1 by T2. Okay, so 1 by T2 is 1 by T2 is your 0.0324 and T2 is your 308.132 Kelvin. So this is the saturation temperature this is saturation temperature at 13.5 kPa. Okay, so answer is your D option 35.2 degree Celsius. Okay. So just you have to use Clausius Capital equation and putting D dash is equal to R T by T and then integrating and then putting the limits. P1, P2 is given, L is given, R is known. T1 is given, you have to find out T2. Okay. Next, 1 mole of an ideal gas Cp is equal to 21 kilojoules per kilomole per degree Kelvin undergoes a constant pressure process from 300 Kelvin to 500 Kelvin. The molar entropy of gas at 300 Kelvin is 150 kilojoules per kilomole per degree Kelvin. The molar entropy in kilojoules per kilomole per degree Kelvin at 500 degree Kelvin up to one decimal place is, here we know that in constant pressure process the entropy is, change in entropy is given by Cp ln T2 by T1. Okay. When we take Cp as molar specificity, so then it is just using molar entropy. Okay. So here T2 is 500, T1 is just 300. Okay. So putting Cp is equal to 21, okay, we can get change in entropy as 10.727 kilojoule per kilomole per liter. Okay. Now the entropy at 300 Kelvin is this, 150 kilojoules per kilomole per liter. Okay. Now entropy, then this is change in entropy, this is entropy at 300, so entropy at 500 will be this. Okay. So this will be 160.727 kilojoules per kilomole. Okay. As the heat is being added, so this the positive change is entropy. Okay, so answer is just 167. Okay, entropy will increase. Okay. Next, a spring having a spring constant of 350 kilonewton per meter is initially compressed by 0.4 centimeter. The work required to compress it by another 0.6 centimeter up to one decimal place is, now it is initially being compressed to 0.4. Now we have to compress it further by 0.6 centimeters. So the total compression is just 1 centimeter. Okay. So the energy stored or the work done in work done for 1 centimeter, work done for compressing 0.4 to 1 centimeter is the, will be the energy stored in the spring during that compression. So work done for 1 centimeter compression is half kx2 square. Okay. So x2 is the total depression, that is 1 centimeter. Okay. And work done for 0.4 centimeter compression is 1/2 k x1 square. X1 is 0.4, x2 is just 1 centimeter, putting k is equal to 350 kilonewton per meter. Okay. So putting this value, we get 14.7 joules. Okay. So answer is 14.7 joules. Putting the value of k as 350 and 350 to 1000. Okay. And this is centimeter converting into meter. So answer is 14.7. Next, an ideal gas has a molar mass of 40 kg per kilomole per degree Kelvin. Take R is equal to 8.314 kilojoules per kilogram per mole Kelvin, per kilomole per Kelvin, at a pressure of 2 bar and temperature of 300 Kelvin. The volume in meter cube of 1 kg of this gas up to 2 decimal places is, here R is your 8.314, okay, and molecular weight is 40. Okay, we can calculate at 2 decimal places, and using this PV is equal to MRT with M 1 kg and P your 2 bar, T 300, we can calculate volume. So answer is your 0.311775. Okay, so this is a simple question. You have to calculate just gas constant, then you have to use ideal gas equation, and then we can do your V. Okay, Question 2 marks question. Consider two pole. Consider the following statement for an ideal gas undergoing a reversible non-flow process. If the process is adiabatic, the change in enthalpy of the gas is necessarily zero. Q. If the process is adiabatic, the change in entropy of the gas is necessarily zero. R. The process is isothermal. If the process is isothermal, the change in enthalpy of the gas is necessarily zero. When the process is adiabatic and it is reversible also, then the enthalpy of the gas is zero. Well, it is not zero. Then the entropy of the gas is zero. The change in entropy of the gas is zero. Because adiabatic process means no heat transfer. It doesn't mean the no heat transfer at concentration. Okay. So entropy should be zero when the process is reversible adiabatic. Okay. Change in entropy should be zero. Okay. But when the process is so second statement is correct, first statement is wrong. Okay. When the process is isothermal and the gas is ideal, then the change in enthalpy should be zero, because when the process is in the ideal gas, the change in enthalpy is given by dH is equal to Cp dT, and as there is no change in the temperature, so change in enthalpy will be zero. So answer is your C. Okay. Answer is your C. Next. So Q and R are correct. Okay. An ideal Otto cycle and ideal diesel cycle have the same maximum temperature and reject equal amount of heat. Also, the working fluid enters at the same state before compression. One of the following statements always true about their efficiency. A. Efficiency of Otto cycle is always greater than efficiency of diesel cycle. B. Efficiency of Otto cycle is equal to diesel cycle. C. Efficiency of Otto cycle is greater than efficiency of diesel cycle. Efficiency of Otto cycle is 1 minus diesel cycle. So, as it is given that maximum temperature is same, okay, so we are keeping the same temperature for both the cycles. And heat rejection is same. So, for one is the heat rejection difference for the both cycles. Okay. Now your 1, 2, 3, 4 is your Otto cycle, and 1, 5, 3, 4 is your diesel cycle. You can see that the work done in the diesel cycle is 1, 5, 3, 4 area of this diagram, and work done for the Otto cycle is 1, 2, 3, 4 area of Otto cycle. Okay, so we can see that the work done for diesel cycle is more than that work done for the Otto cycle for the same heat rejection. So answer is your the efficiency of diesel cycle will be more than answer your C. Okay. Next. A reversible engine receives 75 kilojoules per second of energy from a reservoir at 750 Kelvin. Does 12 kilojoules per second of work, heat is rejected to two reservoirs at 650 Kelvin and 550 Kelvin. The rate of heat rejection in kilojoules per second to a reservoir at 650 Kelvin is option A 11, option D 31, option C 41, option D 52. So this is where a hot reservoir and here Q1 heat is being supplied, and it is the engine is reacting at heat Q2 and Q3 at 650 and 550. Okay, so Q1 is given as 75 kilojoules, and this is 750, and this temperature is your 650 and 550. Okay, so now as the cycle is as the engine is reversible, so we can use Carnot term. According to Carnot term, this Q1 by T1 and Q2 by T2 should be equal to Q2 by T2 and the heat rejection and Q3 by T3. Okay, and so we have Q1, so it will be 75 by 750 and Q2 by 650 and Q3 by 550. Okay, now from the first law, the work done is net heat supplied minus net heat rejected. The heat rejected is Q2 and Q3. Supplied is Q1. So work done is Q1 minus Q2 minus Q3. Okay. So this is the first law. Now Q2 plus Q3 is your 75 minus 12, that is 63. Okay. Now we have Q3 is equal to 63 minus 32. Now we have this equation. We have this equation. Okay. This equation we have got from work done. That is 12 kilojoule. Okay. And this equation we have got from the Carnot theorem. So by putting Q3, because we have to find out the heat rejection to the 650 sink. So by putting Q2, by putting Q3 is equal to 63 minus Q2, we can get the equation in terms of Q2. So also we can, so the heat rejected is 520 by 10, okay, or 52 plus U. By solving all, solving this equation. Okay, so option is your B option. Okay, next. A gas obeys following equation of state P B minus B is equal to R T plus A P square by 2, where B is the model volume, A and B are constant with values A 10 to the power minus 5 joule Kelvin per pascal square kilomole, and B 8 to the power minus 2 meter cube per kilomole. Cp is equal to 30 kilojoule per kilomole per degree Kelvin. At 10 bar and 500 Kelvin, the value of joule Thomson coefficient in Kelvin per pascal is. So you have to remember one formula to solve this question. That is joule Thomson coefficient for real gas. That is joule Thomson coefficient for real gas is this. Unlimited calorie at constant. 1 by Cp T minus only V by quantity P constant minus V. Okay, this is in the chapter of thermodynamic simulation. Okay, so now we have this P, this equation. Okay, and Joule Thomson coefficient in terms of this. Okay, now from this equation we can find out this Curly V by quantity P and V in terms of other quantity. So first finding out this V. Okay, so V will be your V plus RT by P, A P by T. Okay, and currently now again we will now differentiating it, keeping the pressure constant, we get this. Okay, R by P minus A by A P by T square. Now putting this and this here, we get Uj this. Okay, Uj as this. Okay, 1 by Cp minus 2 Ap by T by Ap. Now all the values of this equation are given. That is Cp is your 30, A is your minus 2, 10 to minus 5, B is your 10 to minus 2, and pressure is your 10 bar, temperature is your 500. Okay, so we can put all these values and find out Joule Thomson coefficient, that is minus 4 into 10 to minus 6, option B is the right answer. Okay, next. In an ideal Rankine cycle, three reactors are turbine at 10 MPa and 500 degrees Celsius. H is equal to 3375.1 kilojoule per kilogram. S is equal to 6.5985 kilojoule per kilogram per degree Kelvin. It is cooled in condenser at a pressure of 10 kPa. At 10 kPa, HF is equal to 191.8 kilojoule per kilogram. SF 0.642 kilojoule per kilogram per degree Kelvin. HG is equal to 2583.9 kilojoule per kilogram. And HG is equal to 8.1488 kilojoule per kilogram per degree Kelvin. The heat rejected in the condenser in kilojoule per kilogram is option A 1898, B 3796, C 949, D 2845. Okay, so this is your one. This is the turbine entry point, and this is the turbine exit point. Okay, now we have to calculate heat rejected in the condenser, and this is your heat rejected to condenser, or this is the condenser entry point, and this is the condenser leaving point. Okay, so heat rejected is given by this H2 minus H3. Okay, So we have to calculate H2 and H3 is the saturation liquid enthalpy at lower pressure. Lower pressure is your 10 kPa and higher pressure is your 10 MPa. Okay, now and we have to calculate the dilution layer. Okay, and at 1 and 2 the entropy is constant. Okay, S1 is equal to S2 and at 0.1 the entropy is your 6.995 joules per kilogram per cubic meter. And at 2 the entropy is your in terms of dilution section. Okay, so it will be SG or S3 plus X S23. Okay, and S23 is nothing but SG minus SF. Okay, so SG is your 8.1488 and SF is your 0.6492. Now from this we can calculate the dilution section. Okay, now the dilution section is known, then the heat rejected is given by H3 minus H2. Okay, so this is H2 minus sorry H3 sorry heat rejected is given by H2 minus H3, and H2 minus H3 is nothing but X H23. Okay, so this is X H23. Okay, so answer is your without putting the value H23 is Hg minus this is Hg. Okay, sorry, Hg minus HF into X. So Hg is 2583 and HF is 191.8. Okay, so this is your 1897.2 kJ/kg. Option A is right. Next, methane has compressibility factor value of 0.9 at reduced pressure of 1 and reduced temperature of 1.5. For the propane, critical pressure and critical sorry critical temperature and critical pressure are 369.8 Kelvin and 42.48 bar respectively. Take R is equal to 8.314 kilojoules per kilomole per degree Kelvin, applying the principle of corresponding states. The molar volume of propane at the same reduced pressure and temperature is okay. Now at the same reduced temperature and reduced temperature, both the gases have sorry. Now to solve this question, we have the reduced pressure of methane as 1 and temperature as 1.5. So at the same reduced pressure and reduced temperature, both the gases will have same compressibility factor. Okay, now reduced pressure is given as 1 and reduced temperature is given as 1.5 and Z is given as 0.9. Okay, now it means P by Pc is 1, P by Tc is 1.5. Now Pc is nothing but 42.48 and Tc is nothing but 368. Okay, so this is your this is 42.48 and P is your 554.7. So putting this value we can get sorry this is your 369.8. okay, putting this value we can get P and P. Okay, now at this and now at the same reduced pressure and reduced temperature, now we have the value of pressure and temperature. Okay, and the compressibility factor is 0.9. okay, putting the value of P and R is your universal gas constant. Okay, 8.314 10^3, we can use the answer is 0.977. Option B. Okay, next, a rigid insulated vessel is divided into two compartments by a partition. One compartment contains 12 kg of oxygen at 200 kPa and 280 Kelvin. The other compartment contains 26 kg of carbon dioxide at 400 kPa and 360 Kelvin. The specific heat at constant volume is volume in kilojoules per kilogram per degree Kelvin for oxygen and carbon dioxide are 0.662 and 0.653 respectively. The partition is removed and the gases are allowed to mix considering both the gases are ideal, final temperature of the mixture up to one decimal place. Okay. Now let us the gases given are oxygen and carbon dioxide. With the pressure, temperature, and masses. Okay. Now these two gases are getting are mixed. Now we have to calculate the final temperature. Okay. And specific heat at constant volume of both the gases here. Okay. Now, as molecular weight of oxygen is 32, we can calculate characteristic gas constant of oxygen, and we can calculate similarly we can calculate characteristic gas constant of CO2. Okay. So and CV of both are given. Okay. Using relationship R is equal to CP minus CV, we can calculate CP of all the two gases. Okay. Now two gases are mixed. Okay. And then pressure, temperature, volume, pressure, temperature, masses are given. So change for enthalpy of the first gas, that is O2, plus enthalpy of the second gas, that is CO2, should be equal to total enthalpy after mixing. Okay. Now let us take one by one. Okay. This is the enthalpy of O2. Okay. Initial enthalpy of O2. Okay. And this is the initial enthalpy of CO2. This can also be calculated by using MO2 CP PO2. Okay. For combining this, and this is MCO2 CP O2 TO2. Okay. This can be found like this also. Okay. So this is the initial enthalpy of O2, and this is initial enthalpy of CO2. Okay. Now the final temperature is let TF. So final enthalpy of O2 will be MCP TF, and final enthalpy of CO2 will be MCO2 CP CO2 TF. Okay. This expression can also be written as MCP O2 CO2. Sorry, MCP CO2. PCO2, and this expression can also be written as MCP TO2. If we haven't calculated this, okay, we can use this also. Okay, so by putting the values P naught to MO2 RO2 TO2. Okay, M is given, R we have calculated, TO2 is also known. Similarly, for this PCO2, CV, VCO2, we can calculate this quantity M using MCO2, RCO2, and PCO2. Okay. Now we can put this and this here. Okay. Now this is known. This is M is 12, MO2 is 12, CV we have calculated, CO2 is 20. Okay. Similarly, this is also known. Okay. So putting all these values, okay, we have one unknown value, that is TF. So TF is your 335.07 Kelvin. Okay. So this is the during the Planck constant, the answer is your 335.07. Okay. Next. Moist air having 60% relative humidity enters a steady flow air conditioning unit at 102 kPa and 30 degrees Celsius. Volume flow rate of moist air entering the unit is 0.1 meter cube per second. The moist air leaves the unit at 95 kPa and 15 degrees Celsius with a relative humidity of 100%. The liquid condensate leaves the unit at 15 degrees Celsius. For water at 15 degrees Celsius, properties are given. HF, Hg, P saturation, okay, are given. And for 30 degrees Celsius, the properties are also given. HF, Hg, and P saturation. For the specific heat at constant pressure, For air, the specific area cost is 1.004 kilojoule per kilogram as cost per value, that is specific area cost is going to be 0.287. So this is R, okay? This is not CV. So this is R, specific area cost. Okay. Neglecting the heat leakage to surrounding, it should be 0.72. Okay. Neglecting the heat leakage to surrounding, the magnitude of heat expected. Okay. So we have first condition as 60% humidity and pressure 102 kPa. And temperature 30 degrees Celsius. Okay. And volume is your 0.1 meter cube per second. Now, these are the inlet conditions. Pi 60%, T1 30 degrees Celsius, and saturation pressure at 30 degrees Celsius is this 4.24. Okay. 4.24. Okay. So this is your pi, and from this, we can calculate the vapor pressure, okay, because pi is your PV by PS, okay, so this is your PV, 2.54814 kPa, and similarly the specific humidity, we can calculate the specific humidity is your nothing but 0.62 PV, divided by PV, okay. Now we have PV and total pressure at condition 1 is 102 kPa. Okay. Now we can calculate specific humidity. That is 0.01593 kilogram of water vapor per kilogram of dry air. Okay. Now for dry air, we have PV is MRT. Okay. And R is your 0.287. That value is R. Okay. And MA, now we can calculate MA. That is the total mass of air. Okay. Because we are using the ideal gas equation for air plus water vapor. So we will take the mass MA as to air plus water vapor present in. Okay. That is directly given to that. Okay. So MA is your 0.11729, and the ratio is your. So the summation of the water vapor and dry air is 0.11729, and the ratio is this. So we can calculate MW. Okay, MW is this. Okay, and if we subtract these two, we can get MVA. Okay, so this is the first condition. And in the second condition, Pi2 is your, the second condition Pi2 is 100%, relative humidity 100%, temperature 15 degrees Celsius. And saturation pressure 1.7057 kPa according to 15 degrees Celsius, that is given. Okay. And pi 2 is your, again using that same equation, pi 2 is your PV2 by PS2, we can calculate PV2, and then we can calculate specific humidity in second condition. Okay. Again using same formula but changing PV and PS, and PT is your 95. In the second condition, okay, pressure is 95 kPa, temperature is 15 degrees Celsius, and at 15 degrees Celsius, saturation pressure is 1.7, okay, and relative humidity 100%. Okay, so at the second condition, we can calculate specific humidity. Okay, so this is specific humidity at the second condition, kilogram per kilogram of humidity. Okay, so this is specific humidity, and specific humidity is nothing but, again, the ratio of MW2 and MG, okay, MDA. Now, it is given that liquid condensate leaves the unit at 50 degrees Celsius. Okay, some water vapor condenses, okay, that leaves. Okay, now the water vapor present initially was 0.01849 kilogram. Okay. And the water vapor add the, so as a dry air present is total from the initial condition, total mass of air minus water vapor present, so that is dry air, and the dry air will not go all our dry air will pass through the container, and all of it and dry air will not condense. Okay, so the dry air entering the condenser, entering the entering the air conditioning units, should be equal to dry air leaving the air conditioning to MDA2 equal to MDA1, so that is 0.115441, and specific humidity is this. Okay, now we can calculate from this MW2 to MW2 is this. Okay, so now your MW, initially initial mass of water vapor is this. Okay, and final mass of water vapor is this. Okay, so some amount of water vapor has been condensed into liquid, so that is the condensed liquid. Okay, so the difference of these two is condensed liquid, so this is your condensed liquid. Okay, so to condense the liquid, some heat has been removed from it. Okay, and so to condense the liquid, some heat has been removed from it, and to cool the dry air, some heat has been removed, and to cool the water vapor of this quantity, okay, some heat also has been removed. So heat has been removed from three sources: one by condensing the liquid, okay, other by changing the temperature of water vapor, and third by changing the dry bulb condenser. Cooling the dry air. Okay, so this is the liquid is at gas at vapor condition initially at 30 degrees Celsius. Okay, so we'll take HG 30. Okay, and finally it is at in liquid state, so we'll take HF 50. Okay, this is the mass of liquid. Okay, mass of liquid is this 0.005361. Okay, and the mass of water vapor that has been changed from temperature 30 degree to 15 degree is this. So we'll take HG 30. Okay, and HG 15. Okay, so and MW2 is this quantity. Okay, okay, and then mass of dry air is nothing but this quantity. Okay, and Cp of dry air, Cp of dry air 1.004. Okay, and the temperature difference is 50. Okay, so solving this, we can get 3.11 kW per second of heat reduced. Okay, but now in answer B, the answer was 3.01 to 3.07. So there might be some calculation mistake from the examiner. Okay, so answering was 3.1. Next, at 150 kPa, 323 Kelvin is filled with a rigid vessel of 0.05 meter cube capacity. For air assumed as for the air at one, question number 18 is air at 150 kPa and 323 Kelvin is filled in a rigid vessel of 0.05 meter cube capacity. For air assume air as an ideal gas. Specific heat at constant volume 0.7163 kilojoule per kilogram per degree Kelvin. Specific heat at constant pressure is 0.28. Specific gas constant. So that was also specific gas constant. Specific gas constant is 0.287 kilojoule per kilogram per degree Kelvin. Neglect the kinetic and potential energy. If 30 kilojoule of heat is removed, is added for it, then the final temperature of the air up to 1 decimal place. Okay, so air is at 150 kPa, 323 Kelvin, and volume of air of the tank is this. Okay, so mass of the air vessel is PV by RT. Okay, so this is P and this is v, and r is your y 287, okay, or 287 joule, and t is your 20. So we can calculate the mass of air vessel. Okay, so after calculating mass, we are adding heat of 30 kilo joule. So this will be mcv pf minus ti. So pf is your TF is VF basically, and T initial is 323. Okay, now the vessel is rigid and closed. Okay, so the coastal volume process has to be considered. Okay, so from this we can use TF or TF 840 60. Just you have to calculate the mass of the air and then you go to the volume due dimension. Okay, to find out 500 meters, that will be 840. Okay, next. Superheated steam at 2 bar and 300 degrees Celsius with an enthalpy of 3072.1 kilojoules per kilogram enters a horizontal adiabatic nozzle with negligible velocity and leaves at 0.2 bar as saturated vapor with an enthalpy of 2609.9 kilojoules per kilogram. Assuming steady flow and neglecting the potential energy changes, the exit velocity of steam up to 1 decimal place. So the superheated steam is at 2 bar and 300 degrees. So this is the initial condition, okay, with negligible velocity. So at 2 bar and 300 degrees, the enthalpy is just 3072.1. Okay, so this is the initial enthalpy and, okay, and velocity is 0. Okay, and leaves at 0.2 bar, and enthalpy 2609.9. Okay, okay. So this enthalpy is 260.9 per kilogram. Okay. So this is the entering enthalpy. This is the exit enthalpy. Okay. Now you have to calculate velocity. So just apply the equation and calculate velocity. So see here that is h1. So energy per kilogram is h1 plus v1 square by 2. Here h2 plus here h2 plus v2 square by 2. So v2 is your nothing but
0.1 by 1 minus 3.9 into 2 to 1000 degrees. That is 0.1 liter per second. Okay, next. So answer is given, right? So answer is your 980.1 81. A given mass of a simple compressible substance undergoes reversible cycling as shown in the PV diagram. The magnitude of net work done during the cycle is 3 kJ. The pressure at point C up to 1 decimal place is, so you have to calculate at point C, the pressure at point C. Okay. The work done is given by given as 3 kJ. So it means the area of ABC is 3 kJ. Okay. So area of ABC is 3 kJ. So area under AB is, so area of ABC is, let us calculate the area of ABC. Okay, the area under AB is this whole area. Okay, and this is given as the area under AB. Up to this, let us take this, okay. Area of A, B, and this, okay. So this will be 9 into 10 to 5, and this is 0.021 at 0.06, okay, by 2, okay. This is this area, okay, and this area is your 10 to 5, 0.021 minus 0.06, okay, this area, okay. So area under AB is this 6.7. 50 plus 1500, that is 8250 or 8.250 kilojoule. And area under PC is area under BC is this quantity plus this quantity. Okay, area under this BC is area under AB minus under area under BC area under AB minus area under ABC area under AB minus area under ABC that is 3 kilojoules. Okay, so area under, so this is your 8. Area under AB is 8.250 minus 3, so that is 5.250 kilojoules. So area under BC is your 5.250 kilojoules. Okay. Now again area under BC is summation of these two areas. And this is 5.25, and area under BC is BCD. We have to find out. So this quantity we have already calculated. That is 1500 kilojoules or 1.5. Okay. So the area under BCD is area this BCD. Is, okay. You are. This is also a triangle. This dimension plus this multiplication by 2. So this will be the PC minus PD by 2, and this dimension. Okay, is equal to 3.75. Okay, so this is 3.75. Okay, so PD is your nothing but 1 × 10^5. So all the dimensions are known. Okay, you can use PC. This is also a more. This is also about more of information involving the areas. Okay, so PC is just 6 × 10^5. Okay, what we have done? We have calculated the area under AB. Okay, then by subtracting this area, we get area under this. Okay, by subtracting this area, we get area under this, and this is triangle. So this is P. By the PD, so this area. Okay, so this is the 6 × 10^5. Next, 1 kmol of an ideal gas at 300 Kelvin and 10 bar is reversibly heated in a constant boiling process to 500 Kelvin. It is then reversibly and isothermally expanded to 2 bar. AXCV is equal to 20.8 kilojoules per kilomol per degree Kelvin. R is equal to 8.314 kilojoules per kilomol per degree Kelvin. The total heat supplied in kilojoules to gas up to 1 decimal place. So heat supplied at constant volume is in terms of when mole the data. And molar specific heat transfer NCV T2-CV. Okay, N is your 1 kmol, so take it as 1, and CV is your 20.8 kilojoules per kilomol. Okay, so as the first process is constant boiling process, so heat supply is given by this. Okay, so this is your heat supply 4160. Okay, 4160 kilojoules per kilomol And then the constant temperature of isothermal process takes place in this changing terms of V0, okay, because the process is isothermal. Okay. And then using the first law, we get V2 is equal to DW, that is PDV. Okay. Now, PDV is nothing but R NRT by V, DV. Okay. So this is NRT ln V2 by V1. And it is B2 by V1 is equal to P1 by B2. Okay, P1 is your N bar, and P2 is your 2 bar. Okay, so putting P1 is equal to 10 and divided by 2. Okay, so putting N is equal to 1, R is equal to 8.3, and P is equal to 5. So this is the heat supply during constant temperature process. Okay, and the heat is being supplied during constant temperature process as well as during constant volume process. Total heat is summation of these two. Okay, so answer will be your summation of that constant volume. As only two processes have been performed, so we have to take the heat during both the processes. That is 4160 and 6690. Okay, so total heat energy is this. 10850. So in the answer key, the this is the range given, but I have done it so many times, but I'm only able to get this. Okay. So answer is like this. There is nothing you can check also. A rigid container is completely filled with a liquid having a constant isothermal compressibility of 1.09 in 10 to minus 4 bar minus 1 and the constant coefficient of volume expansion 1.12 10 to minus 3 per degree Kelvin. The liquid is initially at 300 Kelvin and 1 bar. Heat is applied to liquid to raise its temperature to 350. Assuming that no change occurs, the final pressure of the liquid up to 1 decimal place. So here the isothermal compressibility is this. KT is equal to 1 point. Okay. And the formula for isothermal compressibility is minus 1 by V, conductivity T1. Okay. And similarly, the volume expansibility, coefficient of volume expansion is 1 by V, conductivity. Okay, at T1. Okay, so these two quantities are given. So you have to create again this formula. Now, assuming that no pressure, the final, we have to calculate the final pressure. Okay, the liquid is initially at 300 Kelvin, 1 bar, and heat is applied to the liquid, the temperature is 50. The heat, assuming that no phase change occurs, final pressure. You have to calculate that. Now, assume that D is the function of T and P. Okay. Now dV is, now dV can be expressed currently D by currently P constant dT and currently is the currently P constant dT. Okay. Now as the container is completely filled, okay, because heat is being supplied and the container is completely filled, volume will not change. Okay. So volume will not change, then we can take dV as zero. Okay. So this is zero. Okay. So from this two equations we can have this curly V by curly T, P, dT, and this on the left hand side, curly V by curly T, T minus sin V to dT. Now it will be dT dT by dP here, and this will be divided by this. Okay. Now from these two, we get the ratio of this quantity. Okay. This will be 1.09 × 10⁻⁶. Okay, or you can do this. Okay, so dT by dP will be 0.97 × 10⁻¹. Okay, and temperature change is your 300 to 350. So temperature change is your 350. So dP will be 50 divided by 0.97 × 10⁻¹. Okay, so it will be 515.46. So answer is 515.46. Okay, that's from the year 2018. Thank you very much.